Wilkin Gunther reporting, Captain.
Hey, Wilkin.
You got called in too, Faldio?
I apologize for calling the two of you in on an off-duty day. Princess Cordelia has graciously extended banquet invitations to the three of us.
What? But why us?
It seems you two will be recognized for your successes at Vassal and more recent ops. The event will be held tomorrow at the castle.
Oh. I'm not really good with the formal stuff.
What, are you crazy? Do you have any clue how rare a chance to meet the princess is? They say that House Rangreets, the Archdukes of Gallia, are descended from the Valkyra. If that's true, Princess Cordelia herself is a Valkyria, and we get an audience with her.
Well, yeah, I guess.
Just don't forget to wear dress uniforms, gentlemen. I'll meet you both at Castle Randgreaves tomorrow evening. You're dismissed until then.
So much for my plans to go birdwatching tomorrow.
I hope they don't mess this up.
Sorry to keep you, Captain.
Goodness, Wilkin, I hardly recognized you.
Yes, Captain. Alicia helped me get ready this evening. She kept punching me when I told her she couldn't come with me. I'm still sore.
Well, consider it combat experience.
Wow, Wilkin. No grass stains or anything.
Very funny, Faldio. Nice hat, by the way.
Yeah, I never did like the look of these ugly things. I've been boycotting them.
Hey, don't you all look nice?
Good evening, Miss Ellett. Here to cover the banquet tonight?
You know it. Apparently, an ambassador from the Federation's been invited to the party. Now a plan to sign up an alliance between Gallia and the Federation at work here.
But Gallia's national policy has always been to shun alliances and remain neutral.
I figure it's mostly the idea of Prime Minister Borg, Princess Cordelia's regent. He's using her youth as carte blanche to do whatever he and the other nobles want. With all due respect, the princess isn't much more than a mouthpiece for his policies now.
Ugh. We're about to attend a banquet, and now I've gone and lost my appetite.
It's about time to enter. Let's go.
Your Highness, thank you for your presence on this occasion. Might you grace this assemblage with a word?
Honored ladies and gentlemen, if I may, I appear before you today at the peak of joy. For now, two great powers join together. Gallia and the Federation pledge their allegiance as we seek to build together an eternal peace for Europa.
Know this. The honor of dear Gallia, in fact her very freedom, is currently under attack and hangs by the thinnest thread you can imagine. But while Princess Cordelia remains on the throne, she who is the scion of the Valkyra's ancient blood promise, no force on this earth will ever see this nation defeated. Is that not so, Princess?
Yes, I draw strength from the Valkyrian bloodline, and my heart is a repository of justice.
I am nearly at a loss for words. The privilege of brokering peace with you, Your Highness, has been the greatest honor of my life, and I thank you for it. With bountiful stores of ragnite, and your strategic position between East and West, you've become the foundation of Europa. In this time of peril, the Foundation is grateful, and happily joins hands in crushing the Imperial threat before us.
They just want to be sure they're the ones who control us when this is over. Make no mistake, the Federation would conquer Europa the same as the Empire. This is stupid.
It is hard to accept what he's saying.
As long as we fight as one, the Empire's forces will never be a danger.
We shall topple the Empire and rid the world of their threat. And then we shall unify Europa and govern under our great banners.
All of Europa. Well, there's something we haven't heard before.
We're not fighting this war so we can invade another country. Absolutely. All we want is to keep our homes and our families safe.
Now, my friend, let us put an end to all these formalities and raise a glass to honor this historic alliance.
Yes, a toast to the shining future that awaits. Cheers!
Cheers!
Where are you going? I've got a bad taste in my mouth. This is garbage. I'm out of here. I'm going home, Welkin. See ya. Faldio. I'm glad that's over.
We should be heading back soon. I believe the exit was this way. Oh!
Princess Cordelia!
I'm so terribly sorry. Are you all right, Your Highness?
I am unharmed.
I cannot begin to apologize. Please forgive my clumsiness.
Do not trouble yourself. I bid you a safe return and a good night.
Your Highness, are you really in support of an alliance with the Federation?
Lieutenant Gunther, have you lost your mind?
Please forgive me. I'm aware that what I'm saying may be out of line. But seeing you tonight, I got the feeling that your opinion is being ignored.
I am still young. All political matters are handled by my regent, Borg. The protection of Gallia and of the Valkyrian bloodline is my fated onus. Their protection does not require my personal feelings. I need only live by the laws set forth by those who come before me. I bid you once more, good night.
Your Highness.
Do you copy? It's me. The Mark is alone. Now is our chance. You know the plan. Have the armored car on standby. Once I have the Mark, I'll be there.
Well, I'll leave you here. Good night, Welkin.
Good night.
Wait! Hold it, Varat! Varat! Terrible news!
General Damon, what's the problem?
Princess Cordelia's been kidnapped!
Kidnapped? It can't be!
Yes! It was that Federation ambassador! A spy all along!
So the Federation takes her under their protection, and Gallia along with her. Typical, considering the sorts of backroom dealings and extortion they've used till now.
Oh, get on it! Varat, you've got to get her back!
Understood. Lieutenant, gather your squad immediately.
Yes, Captain.
Hey, Casey, what is that thing?
It's an airplane. The first test flight succeeded during EW1. Now research is going on all over the world.
Whoa, so this is what one of those things looks like. Man, I want up in one.
Oh, hello, Leon. Chris?
Hey, Sara, you got the day off. What are you hanging around here for?
Wait, let me guess. Are you building this airplane, Isara?
Yes. There's still a ways to go before it's complete, but the basic construction is done.
Leave it to you, Isara. You learned all this on your own?
I'm working from documents my father collected before his death.
That's amazing. I'm so impressed.
So where are you flying to once it's all done? Going on a Transgallian tour, maybe?
First, I'd like to take my brother up in it. Once, when we were young, he and I were out birdwatching when he mentioned it. That he wished he could fly like they did. That's my goal. I've been pursuing this project bit by bit in my free time.
Oh, that's real sweet!
Isara, can I ask you a favor? Please, let me help you build your airplane.
What?
I want to become an engineer of your caliber someday, Isara. I feel like watching you work would help me learn a great deal. Please, Isara.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Hey, then can I help out too? Come on!
You don't mind?
Of course not. I may not look bright, but I've been working my butt off in R&D for a while.
Of course. Well, thank you both.
All right!
That's the emergency siren.
What's happening at this hour?
Let's ready the Edelweiss. I'm sure that whatever it is, it's urgent.
Absolutely. I'll help you prep it.
We have an emergency on our hands. Princess Cordelia has been kidnapped by Federation operatives. Your mission is to rescue Her Highness unharmed. Failure isn't an option on this one, soldiers.
They can't get to the harbor. We stop them here. Squad 7, move out!
To the harbor, full steam. The ship's waiting there to take us out of Gallia. Apologies for the cramped quarters, Your Highness. We'll have you comfortable soon.
Lieutenant, it's likely the Ambassador has the Princess with him inside that armored vehicle. Use firearms to stop it with minimal force, then recover the Princess. Don't lose them. Tank shells, anti-tank lances, and grenades are off limits. You could harm the Princess.
Understood, Captain.
Welks, even if we can't attack with it, the Edelweiss can still block their path. Yeah, on a narrow road like this, there's no room to slip past a tank in your way.
Sounds like a plan. Let's get the Princess back safe. To tell its position and orientation.
Try to keep a grasp on your surroundings. That vehicle must be stopped immediately.
Okay? Enemy sighted!
What are you doing? Don't stop! Go! Go!
Gallian tank sighted ahead, sir.
Clever little monkeys. We'll take another route.
Tank. That's a militia mod.
Thank you.
vehicle sighted. My turn, okay? Now!
Good. That makes things a bit easier.
My turn, okay? Pull it together.
Man down. Everybody be careful.
Locked in again? They're testing my patience.
Incoming relay, sir. The tank in our way has been identified as Militia Squad 7.
The ones who attended the banquet. Just our luck to be spotted by glory hounds.
Squad 7? That officer from the banquet?
Mr. Ambassador, Allied units have reached their station, sir.
You don't get to be my age without learning to plan for contingencies.
Damn, they had backup waiting in the wings. Keep an eye on enemy positions when moving, Sevens. Entering combat!
Don't let a chance slip past you! Don't come out of cover until you have to!
My turn, okay? Enemy sighted!
Take care of it. Today's the wrong day to mess with me.
Please don't let up on the offense.
I'll take care of it.
Man down. Everybody be careful.
No problem, boss.
Open.
Here I go. Go, go, go.
Please hurry, everyone.
Malcolm dead. Medic!
Just a little longer. Almost there.
Don't leave cover without good reason.
Enemy found. I'm on it.
Leave it all to me. Today's the wrong day to mess with me. Take care of it. Today's the wrong day to mess with me. Ha!
I can't get a visual.
Wait a bit longer and see how they move.
Ambassador, the vehicle's taking damage. It won't last long at this rate.
Make it last long enough. It just needs to get us to that harbor. As soon as the princess is on Federation land, we'll own this little country.
The vehicle's taking heavy damage. It won't be long now. Complete. Let's get Her Highness out of there.
Your Highness, are you all right?
I am unharmed. Oh, good.
Being princess ain't all fancy dinners, huh? Gotta be hard carrying a whole country.
Can it, Rosie? That's the Princess of Galia you're talking to.
No, it's quite all right. She speaks the truth. As scion of the Valkyrie, it is my fate to live and die for Galia's well-being.
Are you sure that isn't just your excuse, Your Highness?
What?
If you label the status quo fate, you can run from the responsibility of changing it.
You too, Welkin. Have a little respect here.
Every living thing in this world struggles to live and pass life on to a new generation. They use all the instincts and animal wisdom they can just to live that one day longer. That powerful animal will to live is... I think it's a beautiful part of nature.
Your Highness may be descended from Valkyra, and that may carry a burden. The old ways and traditions you follow may be important to uphold. But I hope that you won't throw away the will to live your own life because of them.
That's enough, Welkin. Give it a rest.
Perhaps it is as you say, and I have been running from responsibility unknowingly. It is indeed mine to consider my life's role within the Valkyrian bloodline.
Your Highness.
I am most envious of your ability to speak your mind so frankly. But time enough remains to consider my role by my own will. Thank you for your words, Lieutenant.
Not at all.
Wow! Even a princess's gut'll wake up and say hi when it's empty.
I am.
Rumbling bellies are a clever bit of animal wisdom all humans share. Alicia, have we got anything to eat?
You bet. I brought some of the cinnamon rolls I baked this morning. Here you are, Your Highness.
Thank you kindly. I have not had such bread before, but it is quite agreeable.
I'm glad.
All right, let's get Her Highness back to the capital.
And so Princess Cordelia returned, safe through the efforts of Militia Squad 7. Its leader, Welkin Gunther, was celebrated as rescuer to the nation's sovereign and awarded the prestigious Gallian Medal of Honor.
Lieutenant Welkin Gunther, step forward.
Sir!
For excellence in valor and deed, you are hereby awarded this honor. Your Highness, please bestow the medal upon the young lieutenant.
Gladly. Congratulations, Lieutenant Gunther.
Thank you, Your Highness.
Though I have yet to reach an answer, your question drives me still. To understand my responsibility as sovereign and as a single human life.
Your Highness.
Oh, and know that one tradition already lies sundered by my will. I had the cooks add cinnamon rolls to my daily breakfast.
Alicia will be happy to hear it.
Lieutenant Gunther, you forget yourself.
Sir, my apologies.
With this, today's ceremonies are ended. Highness, would you grace us with a word?
Lieutenant Gunther, I hope your allegiance to Gallia stands firm evermore.
Yes, Princess.
Welkin, I'm coming in.
Sure, it's open.
Ooh, is that it? Not bad, man. You sure made a name for yourself this time.
It was pure luck I was there.
So have you seen the headlines? The ones that say nothing about the kidnapping? That reporter tells me Borg's the one pressuring the media into suppressing it.
Why suppress it?
If word got out about what happened, Gallia's relationship with the Federation would suffer. We've got our hands full fending off the Empire. We can't afford a war on two fronts. So he has the whole thing covered up. I'll bet he goes on acting like it never happened.
Wow.
Welkin, this hurts. It's painfully obvious how shaky Gallia's standing is.
I know the world's history is an endless chain of big fish eating little fish.
Both of us know the weak bow to the strong. It's history and its nature. A minor nation like ours is an easy mark, even before you add the rift within our army. Welkin, no offense, but I hope nature's wrong this time.
I don't know what to tell you, Faldio.
Chapter 10, Liberation of Fausen.
Come back and...
Da-da-da-da! Thanks a million! Come back!
I'm sorry. I hope...
How have you been, Your Highness?
Very well, Lieutenant Gunther. And all the better for seeing you again. I thank you again for the valor you showed in assisting me that night.
Not at all. I was just relieved to see you were unharmed, Highness. It wasn't until I saw my friends gawk at that medal that I realized how special it was.
You truly are a rare individual. It is the duty of a nation to acknowledge and reward the loyal deeds of its people. Medals and trinkets are the only form we have. We ask that you wear them proudly.
Yes, ma'am. And thank you, Your Highness.
I hear your accomplishments do not end with that knight's bravery either. The stories of your accomplishments suggest I owe you a great deal more than that. Lieutenant Welkin Gunther, step forward. In honor of your manifold accomplishments, you are hereby awarded this honor.
Highness, it's an honor.
May your allegiance to Gallia stand firm evermore. Heart to see you alive and well. Already on your way back to base? Time is a fickle friend indeed. May your allegiance to Gallia stand.
R&R.
Figure this has got to be big if they put out an emergency call, right?
Ah, back into the field again? Militia ever heard of time off?
I'm sorry to have called you here so early. I had news for Squad 7 of a pressing nature. The higher-ups were watching, both during your recovery of the princess and elsewhere. In recognition of those accomplishments, you and I are being granted special leave.
Ooh!
That's great news!
Are you serious?
Music to my ears!
How wonderful!
There's more. We've been granted access to a stretch of shoreline owned by House Randgreaves.
House Randgreaves owns a stretch of shoreline?
In other words, our orders are to cut loose and relax on a posh private beach.
No way. That princess really knows how to up the morale, don't she?
The whole place to ourselves. Talk about luxury.
Hey, but what should I do? I don't own a swimsuit.
Then come on, let's go shopping. I'll pick out something nice for you.
Okay.
Wow, it's been years, huh? This should be fun, though, Ys.
Yes, very.
We'll leave as soon as you're ready. You've earned this break. Enjoy it. Dismissed.
You can really tell this is a private beach. It's beautiful. The water's so blue. There's not many places this well-preserved around anymore. Look at those white wings.
Hi, Welkin. This, swimsuit was Rosie's idea. Really, I tried to tell her no. I wasn't sure I could pull it off. What do you think? Do I look okay?
It's great, actually. Great.
You mean it?
Huh? Yeah. That is, you're as pretty as a white-winged gull.
I look like a seagull?
Yeah. Those wings are just gorgeous.
Okay, so that was a compliment?
You bet it was. A white-winged gull is just about my favorite bird.
Okay. Then thanks, Welkin.
Someone's taking this private beach thing a little too literally. It's already hot enough as it is.
Rosie!
Don't try to pretend. You picked the raciest suit just for the lieutenant, the nerve of some girls.
Rosie, you're the one who told me to get it.
Okay,
someone's going in the water.
Okay. Don't lose your top.
Hey.
Hey, Welks.
Oh, hey, Ys. You having fun?
I am.
Been a while since we've come to the beach, hasn't it?
Yeah.
That reminds me. Weren't you afraid of the water, Ys? I remember you clinging to that floaty Porcavian. We tried to drag you out and you started bawling.
Welkin, I was barely a toddler then.
Right, sorry. You must be a great swimmer by now.
That's none of your business. Here goes, Welkin.
Ah!
Mike?
And down goes the boss. Man, those kids got too much energy.
You're sounding like an old man, Largo.
What? I ain't that old.
Oh, no. Then why did you just sound like my grandfather, hmm?
Yeah. You sure you don't want to go for a swim? I thought you liked that.
Nobody wants to see me running around in a skimpy suit like those kids. Not at my age.
Whatever you say, Granny. You're no better than I am, are you?
You haven't changed a bit since the day you enlisted. You still can't recognize a joke.
You still got a mouth on you. Think I'd keel over if that changed.
Thank you for the lovely compliment.
Come to think of it, didn't we all go to the beach just after we enlisted?
Yes, we had a big seashell hunt competition. I don't think you found a single one.
I remember. Yeah, that was a wild time. Then Frederick winds up soaked to the bone.
Largo, no Frederick stories.
Oh, hey. I'm sorry.
No, I should apologize. I'm going for a little walk.
Well.
East, over here. Pass the ball over here.
Isara, nail him. Go. Okay.
Oink.
Hans, did I hit you with that? I'm so sorry.
She nailed the pig.
All by yourself, huh? Why don't you go join them?
Nah, that's not my thing.
Mm-hmm. Always have to play it cool, huh?
So what, did your journalist duties call you to the beach, or are you just bored?
Got me there. If I'm spending a day at the beach, I'd rather be with my boyfriend.
Oh ho ho! You got yourself a boy, do ya? Color me jealous.
Right? But there's times when I feel envious of you all, too. I interviewed a good chunk of Galia's army, but I didn't see any other units like yours. True comrades. The bond you guys have is really a cut above the rest. Get over there already. They're all waiting for you.
Well, I could take pity on them. And it's not like chatting with an old married lady is any fun.
You're a piece of work.
All right, guys, make room for me.
Oh, a promising contender joins the fray. Rosie, think you could pair up with Isara?
What? Sure, fine. Isara, pull your weight or you're swimming.
Okay, I'll do my best, Rosie.
All right. Throw the ball, Isara.
Okay.
God, don't hit me with it. You're supposed to throw it that way.
Rosie, did I hit you with that? I'm so sorry.
We've been given orders for our next mission. The militia is taking back the city of Fausen.
Fausen's that big industrial city with all those ragnite mines, right?
Yes. If we manage to reclaim it, it'll be a shot in the arm to Galia's productivity.
Sounds good. So what's the plan, boss?
The militia will break up into squads and set up a perimeter around the city. Once that's set, Squad 7 takes the point. Here, look at this.
An armored rail vehicle?
Right. They installed it to defend their hold on the city. Now our mission is to destroy it.
Yeah, okay, so we destroy it. Any idea how we take on a beast like that? Gonna take a lot more than a pack of soldiers marching at it to do that, boss.
Don't worry. We've got some hefty support on this one.
Support? Like who?
You know that Darksons from Empire-held areas have been brought there, right?
I've heard stories, yes. That they're being used as forced labor in the Ragnite mines and weapons factories.
According to Captain Barat, one of the men in the camps is acting as our agent.
Here I get my hopes up and it's just some dark hair. Got any more great news?
What do you mean by that?
I'm just saying, I hope this guy's not as stubborn as someone else we know.
Please stop judging people solely by your preconceptions. All Darksons are different.
Sure could have fooled me. I couldn't tell you dark hairs apart if I tried.
I don't believe you have ever really tried, Rosie.
No, you just didn't.
Just drop it already. We're soldiers. We'll do our best out there. If the orders say work with a Darkson, we do. That said, I ain't making any promises if this guy turns out to be useless. Here.
Well, we can't know for sure until we meet him, but the mission hinges on him. We begin the march on Fausen at first light. The attack begins at sundown.
Oh, the stench is unbearable.
Please, some food, sir. Even water would...
Keep your distance. Presumptuous, dark-haired, filthy. Where is the one responsible for this hovel?
You rang?
I hear a worker in Sector D has been disobeying his work orders. Would you care to explain this infraction?
He's not disobeying you. He's been sick as a dog for a couple of days now. Folks from other camps working D Sector have gotten sick lately too. One's in a coma. That's where they handle Ragnite Refinery. Sure the toxic exhaust's being handled right?
That's no concern of yours or mine. You animals need only be silent and obey.
Let's think of it this way. You drive them to death and the work stops getting done. That doesn't help you much, eh? I'll let you know as soon as he can work. Think you could let him rest for now?
Very well. Have him return to work the minute he's able. And remember, no one would miss the likes of a few of you maggots.
Here is your mission brief. If there are no questions, let's get started. I wish you good luck and happy hunting.
Our top priority is to get to the rendezvous point. Squad 7, move out!
Well, this is Fausen. Looks like a complicated layout.
Let's move carefully here. We don't want to be spotted.
Ready for action.
Lieutenant Gunther, you may be able to move unseen using the trolley cars around town. Their path is fixed, and they can only fit one person, but they may get you behind the enemy.
Enemy sighted. Get ready!
Alert! Alert! You're on enemy turf!
Did you see that?
Nice work! Keep taking them down! Time your shots carefully, soldiers.
The labor camp is up ahead. Continue your advance.
Enemy spotted. Enemy sighted. Get ready. Yeah, I can do that. Did you see that?
I'm impressed, but not surprised.
It's like, enemy sighted. Get ready.
Strike when you see an opening.
Yeah, I can do that.
Nice work! Keep taking them down!
Yeah, I can do that. Did you see that?
Good work. Keep it up.
Say so. So long. See what you get?
Good work. Keep it up.
You can all do this. Stay strong. lightning.
So long!
Nice work! Keep taking them down!
Be careful! If they get those searchlights on you, you'll be dodging mortars. Avoid the lights at all costs. If they find you, take evasive action immediately.
Don't look down, Philip.
Right, here I go.
Open.
I see one.
Okay, I got it.
Ready for action.
Try not to take any needless actions. If you see an opening, strike it.
Tighten all perimeters!
Lines made enemy contact. Support them. Tank command.
This is getting hairy.
Ready for action.
Make sure you stay calm. Speed is the key to mission completion.
Ready for action.
Sounds like rule.
We scouts gotta get along, huh?
Enemy sighted. Get ready.
Do all you can to minimize cats.
Entering combat.
Watch the distance between you and the enemy.
Watch this.
He is full of smog.
Entering combat!
Now's your chance!
Entering combat! Hostile sighted!
Keep abreast of the situation!
Entering combat!
You have a visual on the enemy.
Entering combat! entering combat. Gotta love nature. Combat. Gotta love nature.
Found an enemy.
I wouldn't advise looking down. You'll lose your nerve.
Time to do your duty, soldiers.
Enemy sighted. Get ready.
Go!
Here we go!
Those poor people won't be there to help.
On the move now.
Just watch this.
Say so.
So long.
Keep abreast of the situation.
Do this thing.
My turn, okay?
Say so.
Yeah.
for action.
Please continue advancing. The target is up ahead.
Enemy spotted. Enemy sighted. Get ready.
Try to time your shots carefully.
Did you see that?
Target silenced.
Found an enemy. What'd I do to you? Did you see that?
You're doing well. Just keep it up.
Look.
Here we go! Gotta love nature.
Soil.
have a visual on the enemy.
Combat! Gotta love nature. Minor damage sustained. Entering combat! Gotta love nature. Entering combat! Entering combat!